So atmospheric pressure we'll be discussing. This year most of the we have discussed in geography. So we have the envelope of air surrounding the earth. And this envelope of air, it consists of various gases and it exerts pressure on the earth's surface. It exerts pressure on the earth's surface. And we have discussed with height, the pressure decreases. That means maximum pressure is at the sea level. Maximum pressure is at the sea level. That is the lowest point. The maximum pressure will be there. And the reason for the maximum pressure, we can consider atmosphere as layers. Layers of different gases. Layers of gases. Okay. And this layer, if we consider this layer, above it many layers are there. So each layer is exerting force. Each layer is exerting force on the layers lying beneath. Therefore, as we come towards the earth's surface, the pressure keeps on increasing. Pressure keeps on increasing. So as height decreases, pressure increases. And there's one more reason. Density of air as well increases as we are coming towards the earth's surface. And we have discussed as well in geography that around 80% of the total gases lies in the troposphere. 80% of the total weight of the gases lies in the troposphere. So the density decreases. So here the density decreases in this fashion. That is maximum decrease in the troposphere, then it goes on slowly decreasing. Okay. So that's why maximum pressure is at the near the surface, near the earth surface, we can say, or the at the sea level. So atmosphere is envelope of gases. Now, how much force does it exert? How much pressure is the atmosphere pressure? So at the mean sea level, it is around 10^5 Newton per meter square. It means on an area of 1 meter square. On an area of 1 meter square, the pressure is this much, 10^5 Newton. This much huge pressure is applied on this 1 meter square area. This is a atmospheric pressure, that is force or the thrust per unit area. That is our pressure. And our body, on our body, we feel around 2 × 5 Newton per meter square. So on our body, this much pressure is being applied by atmosphere. We do not feel this pressure. We do not feel this tremendous pressure because our blood pressure is slightly more than this pressure. Is slightly more than this pressure. That's why whenever a small cut happens, blood oozes out. Because blood pressure is more as compared to this atmospheric pressure. Okay. And as the height increases, atmosphere pressure decreases. That's why at high altitudes, what happens? As we go at high altitude, the atmosphere pressure decreases. The blood pressure, the difference between the atmosphere pressure and blood pressure is more. And that's why nosebleeding may happen. Nosebleeding may happen because the difference in the atmosphere pressure and the blood pressure is huge as altitude increases and nosebleeding starts. This is clear. Now we do an experiment to demonstrate atmospheric pressure. Okay. So for this, what we'll do? We'll take one tin can. A tin can with an airtight stopper we are taking. Okay. Now we have filled some water. Okay. Now inside the can we have the water and the air. Okay. And atmosphere pressure is there. Okay. Now we start to boil the water. Water starts to boil the air inside the can. It is replaced with steam, with water vapor. Air inside the can is replaced with steam. Steam replaces the air. Now we put the stopper. Okay, we close the opening. Now it is sealed. We have sealed the opening. We remove the burner. Now, see here. At this time, the pressure inside and outside is same. But now we pour cold water. As we pour cold water, what will happen? This steam will condense and most of the steam will again convert to water. And here, pressure decreases. Here, pressure decreases. Okay, there's one more thing. We know that steam occupies more space as compared to water. The same amount of, take some amount of water, if it is converted to steam, it will occupy very large space. Therefore, now as cold water is poured, the steam converts back to water. Now the pressure inside the tin can decreases. Pressure inside the tin decreases. And what pressure is acting from outside? That is the atmospheric pressure. Now there is a difference in pressure. So what will happen to this thin tin can? It collapses. It gets collapsed. So this is how we can demonstrate the effect of atmospheric pressure. This is clear?
Sir, can you please explain again? Not understood.
What you haven't understood?
So that when how the pressure, the steam pressure inside and the air pressure.
Okay. See, we have taken a thin tin can. Okay. We filled it with water. Okay. Which starts to boil. So air inside the can, it is replaced by with steam. It is replaced with steam. We remove the burner as well. We seal the opening. A lid we put, we seal the opening. This is thin can. Now see here what happens. At present, the pressure inside and outside is same. Okay. At present, pressure inside and outside is same. Okay. But as we pour cold water over the thin can, what happens? The steam condenses. It is converted back to water. Most of the steam condenses and back to the water, it returns. Now the pressure decreases. The reason for decreasing pressure is that water, when converted to steam, it occupies more space. You can feel that pressure in pressure cooker. Pressure cooker, we have. You filled some water. Now, as water starts to boil, you can see the lid get stuck because of the more pressure from inside, because of the steam pressure. And steam oozes out through the what we call it, through the stopper, is there?
CT? Vessel.
Yes, vessel is there. Okay, this is fine. Understood. So same happens here. So I tell you again from start what is happening, step by step. First we take the lid tin can. We have taken it. So what is it filled with? Air, outside air as well. We fill some water inside it. We filled water. Now, what is there? Inside air as well, outside air as well. So here as well, atmospheric pressure acting. Here as well, atmospheric pressure acting. So on the walls, same pressure is being acting. So tin remains in the same position. Okay. Now, what we do? We close this. We start to boil the water. So the air inside escapes. And in place of air, what takes? The steam. Now, in this thin tin can, steam is there, steam and water, okay? And the pressure inside as well outside is same, since it is open, so pressure is same. Now, we remove the burner and we close the lid. We close the opening. Now, what happens? Water was there, steam was there. Okay, we have closed the opening. At present as well, pressure inside and outside is same. Okay, now as you pour cold water over this thin can, so what happens as you pour cold water? This steam condenses and it is converted back to water. Most of the steam gets converted back to water. So steam, when condensed into water, it occupies less space Therefore, a little kind of vacuum, a little vacuum is being created, not in terms of vacuum here. So your pressure will decrease inside the can, pressure will decrease, but outside from all sides, which pressure is acting on this can?
Atmospheric pressure.
Now see here, as we have kept on pouring the cold water, the pressure keeps on decreasing because steam is getting converted back to water. So less space it will be occupying as it gets converted to water. So pressure keeps on decreasing and the can starts to collapse. See, and can starts to collapse because there's a difference in pressure. Understood?
Yes, sir, so this, understood.
This is how we can demonstrate atmospheric pressure, that is, it is acting. Okay, now some of the applications we will discuss, or we can call consequences, results of atmospheric pressure. Okay, one is drinking soft drinks or water. Okay, so what we do? We pour water or Coca-Cola or anything like that, and we have inserted a straw. Okay, so in straw as well, the liquid will rise to the same level. Okay, now which pressure will be acting? Atmospheric pressure will be acting. And here we have the mouth, called eye. Okay, now see here, as we start sucking, so first what will be sucked? Air inside the straw, it will be sucked in our lung. So here what happens? As we have sucked the air, this will be like a vacuum. So here will pressure will decrease. Okay, consider this as the straw. Okay, so air here is being sucked in. Air here is sucked in. So here pressure reduces. So on this layer of water or on the liquid, pressure reduces. Here pressure is reduced, but here which pressure is being acting? Atmospheric pressure. And because of this difference in pressure, what will happen? This liquid will rise. It will move up. And this is how we can drink the liquid using straw. Understood? So there is a difference in pressure. As you suck the, as you start sucking, first the air is being taken out from the straw. It is being sucked inside our lungs. And then as the difference in pressure generates, here low pressure, here high pressure. So this liquid rushes in and rises, and that's how we can drink the liquid. This is clear. Any doubt in this? Next is syringe. So while injection is being injected, what this is a plunger. Okay. So first in syringe, what we do? We press the plunger to the till the base so that all the air from inside the syringe is being moved out. Now the tip is being inserted in the liquid. Tip is being inserted in the liquid, and we pull up the plunger. We pull up the plunger. As we pull up the plunger, what will happen inside? Here, vacuum will be there. So pressure will reduce, and on liquid, which pressure is acting? Atmospheric pressure. Again, there is a difference in pressure. So this liquid gets sucked in. This liquid gets sucked in. This is how our syringe works. On the same phenomena, on the same way, our fountain pen works. We have the nib, and then capillary, and then this tube is there. Okay. So what we'll do? We press the tube. We switch the tube. The rubber tube is being provided in fountain pen. We switch the rubber tube, and what happens? The air inside is being pushed out, and you can see the bubbles in the ink. Air inside is being pushed out. Now we release it. So what happens? Here pressure reduces, and here atmospheric pressure is acting. So this liquid, the ink, is being pushed inside the tube. Okay. And see here, if we take the fountain pen to high altitudes, or in space, if we take at high altitudes, what happens? Pressure inside the tube will be more as compared to outside, because some air bubbles may be inside the tube as well. Some air bubble is as well inside the tube. So what happens at high altitude? What happens? The air inside, this pressure is more, as compared to outside pressure. So it expands, air expands, and it pushes the liquid out. That's how this pen leaks at high altitudes. This is clear, fountain pen, any doubt?
So can you repeat that, what happens when we take this fountain pen at high altitude?
Okay, consider this as the, okay, this is our nib, okay? This is our tube, okay, rubber tube is there. Now see here, as we fill the, it is filled with ink and some air is as well there. Some air bubbles maybe are inside the tube. This is fine. Now what happens at high altitude? Outside we have the atmosphere pressure and inside this as well. At present, the pressure inside and outside is same, okay? But as we take at high altitudes, pressure outside, atmosphere pressure decreases. Atmosphere pressure decreases. So what happens? There's a difference in pressure and the pressure here, the air here, it starts to expand. It starts to expand because less pressure is there. Under pressure, if on air we apply more pressure, it gets compressed. If less pressure is there, it starts to expand. So it starts to expand and the, this ink is being leaked out. It is pushed out because of the difference in pressure created.
So just now you told us about that steam experiment.
Yes.
When we are pouring cold water, the tin shrinks or it collapses. So can this also happen that it may burst?
For that, okay. For bursting, see, with cold water, it won't burst. Okay. Tin is malleable, so it won't burst. See here. It will burst if, see here, water we are boiling, if we keep on boiling and we have closed the opening. So what will happen? Steam pressure will build. Inside the pressure will be very huge. Inside pressure will be very huge. Outside pressure. So till this thin tin can hold this pressure, it will be fine. But it starts to expand now because difference in pressure will be there. We are boiling it. What is getting converted into steam? Water gets converted into steam. Steam pressure will be huge inside and the difference in pressure will be increasing and it will expand. And there will be one moment that is it bursts. So this happens with pressure cooker as well. There is one safety valve has been provided. You have seen? See here. Here is the whistle. And this is the handle. Below handle, you can see one stop valve. Safety valve is there. Okay. That safety valve, it's of metal such that, see here, before the at particular pressure develops, at that pressure, it opens. It opens. And it saves our pressure cooker from being damaged.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Next, we discuss rubber suckers. Okay, they have been mainly used in kitchens and bathrooms. So on a smooth
wall.
Yes.
Sir, the tin is malleable, so it will not burst.
See here. First, it is expands, but there's a limit of expansion. After that, either the crack will happen, or since the difference in pressure is huge, even a small crack happens, the whole steam will try to rush from it out. Will try to rush and it will burst.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Because iron through a small opening, this whole steam will try to rush out. Okay. So now we discuss rubber sucker. Okay. So for example, we have the wall. This is our wall. Okay. Mainly it works, rubber suckers works on a smooth wall. Okay. So what happens? So first we press the rubber sucker. First we press the rubber sucker. So what happens? Air inside. It is being pushed out. It is being pushed out. Now we release. So here inside, here, vacuum is being created. Here vacuum is being created. Now see here, from outside, atmosphere pressure is acting. From outside, atmosphere pressure is acting. But from this side, vacuum is there. So this rubber is being stuck on the ball. It will stuck on the ball because from outside atmospheric pressure is being applied. This is clear. And mainly our lizards as well walks on this principle. They can walk on the wall mainly because of this. They're having small suckers on their legs. This is clear rubber sucker. You've seen them below the glass as well. On tables as well, they are being pulled. Okay, rubber suckers. Action of siphon system. This you have done many times, mainly while removing water from the cooler tank. Okay, so what happens? See here, we are having two tanks. For example, we have to fill water from this tank to tank A to tank B. Okay. So how we can fill the water? We can use one pipe, rubber or glass tube we can use. And which pressure is acting? Atmospheric pressure acting. So see here, now what we do? We put our mouth on the other end and we suck the air inside. So inside the tube, the pressure decreases. Inside the tube, the pressure decreases. A kind of vacuum is being created and this liquid, it is being pushed inside the tube. Because of the difference in pressure, because of the difference in pressure here and there. And water rises, now it flows. Okay. Now, because of gravity, it will keep on flowing. And this will be, this water will be transferred from tank A to tank B. This you have done mostly, I think. Everyone has tried once.
Yes, sir.
This is siphon system. Okay, taking out oil from a sealed can. Okay, now see we are having can we have, this is our can. Okay, now see here, for taking out the oil from the can, what we usually do, we make a hole and we tilt it. We make a hole and we tilt it. As we tilt it, see what happens. Oil may not come or comes in very less quantity. So see what is happening inside the inside the can. We have the liquid, the oil we have. Now outside from outside, atmospheric pressure is acting, and inside the pressure because of the liquid column. The pressure at this point will be because of the liquid column. And here on the top, a little vacuum is being created. So the moment this pressure, because of the liquid column, is equal to the atmospheric pressure. Liquid won't come out. Liquid won't come out. So what we usually do? We make a small hole on the other side, on the upper end. On the upper side, we make a small hole. So what happens here? Okay, consider this as the can. Okay, we made a small hole here, and this was the liquid, this was the oil here. And here, it has to come. And here, atmospheric pressure is acting on this end. And here, till we haven't made the hole, what is the pressure inside is because of this liquid column. Okay? And this pressure is less as compared to this atmospheric pressure. Because of this liquid column, because of the oil column, the pressure generated inside is less as compared to the atmospheric pressure outside. And liquid won't come out. So what we do, we make a small hole on the other end. We make a small hole on the other side. So from other end, air rushes out and it applies force. It applies force and pressure is being there. This is equal to atmospheric pressure. Now see here, inside the can, how much pressure is there? Because of the liquid column plus atmospheric pressure. Outside, only the atmospheric pressure. So inside, more pressure is there as compared to outside pressure. So liquid comes out. This experiment you can do as well. For example, you can take a bottle, the plastic bottle, close with it and make a small hole. Very small hole you make it, water won't come out if you tilt. But if you make a hole on the other side, it will start to rush out. Okay? Understood this one? This is very important. Have you understood this one?
The hole which we have made too.
Yes.
Sir, one hole we have made below and one hole we will make at the top. Sir, then atmospheric pressure will not equalize. They will not become zero.
Zero how? See, okay, see it. Okay, we have made on the top we made one hole and then we tilt it. Okay, then we tilt it. So this is the base of the can and this is the top of the can. Okay, we have tilted the can to take the oil out. Okay, now see here, for example, this is our oil level. This is our oil. So at present, what pressure will be acting at this end? It will be atmosphere pressure. At this end, atmospheric pressure is acting. Okay. See, inside the can, it is a closed can. Here, the pressure, and here the vacuum will be there. Okay. Here, the pressure will be because of this oil column. This height of the oil, pressure will be only because of this height of the oil. Okay. And this pressure is less as compared to atmospheric pressure. This pressure is less as compared to atmospheric pressure. And liquid won't come out. The oil won't come out. Okay. Now see here, as we make one hole on the base, as we make one hole on the base, what happens? Air from outside will rush in. And it exerts pressure. And here the pressure exerted will be equal to the atmospheric pressure. Okay. Consider here the atmospheric pressure as P naught. Okay. Here as well, atmospheric pressure is P naught. Okay. So here, what pressure is acting? Atmospheric pressure. And here, what pressure? Atmospheric pressure plus pressure because of oil column. So at this point, inside, this pressure will be there. And outside, only the atmospheric pressure. This pressure is more as compared to atmospheric pressure on the outside. And because of this difference in pressure, the liquid will come out. Understood this time?
Yes,
if you have doubt, you can ask again. This is important.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, this we are doing to take the liquid out.
Yes.
Sir, so why we are making a small hole? We can make a big hole and we can take it out easily. No need to make two holes.
Yes, that's true. We make a big hole. Okay, see here what happens? We make a big hole, okay? So what happens? As the oil is coming out, air bubbles as well. Air will be as well entering through the same hole. And you will see it won't be a streamlined flow. The flow will be, some oil will come out after some oil, sometime. This how. You have seen it?
Yes, sir, seen.
Okay. If we make the bigger hole, more bigger hole, then we won't be able to discuss this. Understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Practically, we always make a bigger hole and we use that one. Okay. So in that case, as liquid comes out, air as well keeps on entering. You have seen it in water bottle as well. You can see, you can witness that. Okay, now I discuss a little bit about barometer.
So time's up.
Yeah, you did. Okay, then 11:45 we'll have geography. Okay, barometer, just go through it once. Okay, just I will take 2 minutes. Barometer is easy. So in barometer, what we usually do, we take a vessel, a through we take, and a tube. Okay, first we take the tube and fill it with mercury. Around 1 meter length of tube we take and we fill it with mercury, okay? And we press the thumb and we insert in it through containing mercury. So we have the mercury here inside. Now see here, what happens as we invert it and remove our thumb? This mercury level starts to decrease. At one point, it stops. At one point, it stops. Now see here, outside pressure, what is acting? This is atmospheric pressure. At all this point will be atmospheric pressure. And here, at this point, what pressure is acting? That is because of this liquid column, because inside it's vacuum. So because of this liquid column. So pressure here at this point, PA, here PB. So when the pressure at this point becomes equal, this liquid movement of this liquid, movement of the mercury stops, okay? So initially what happens? It is completely filled. That means here the pressure is more as compared to the pressure outside. Here the at this point the pressure is more as compared to this point. So what happens? The liquid moves out from the tube and here the level rises. Okay, it will rise till the pressure at these two points becomes equal. So at that point, when the liquid stops, that is mercury stops, we can say whatever pressure is being exerted by this liquid column, by this mercury column, is same as the pressure applied here. And here which pressure? Atmospheric pressure. That means atmospheric pressure is equal to the this one. Pressure because of the mercury column, H rho g. So mainly we used to denote this pressure in terms of height as well. What is the height of the mercury column? That is, it is usually 76 centimeters or 0.76 liters. So in height of the mercury column, we can as well denote the pressure. Okay, for example, atmospheric pressure increases. As atmospheric pressure increases, here as well, there will be difference in pressure. Here more pressure, here less pressure. So mercury level will rise. Okay, if outside pressure is low, mercury level will drop. Understood this one? This is barometer. More we'll discuss in next lecture. Okay. Okay then. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I try to find out the question answers of geography we'll discuss today. Cyclones we'll discuss, and then we'll discuss the question answers. Okay. Thank you.